Welcome you in this video tutorial. In this video tutorial, we are going to discuss, can we override or overload a static method in Java? To set the context for understanding a static method overloading and a static method overriding in Java, first, let's have a little introduction of what is overloading and what is overriding. So how we can define method overloading? Well, we can define method overriding when two or more methods within the same class or within the parent-child relationship classes have the same name, but the parameters are different in types or numbers, the methods are said to be overloaded, right? That's the basic definition of method overloading. Then what is overriding? Before try to understand what is method overriding, let's try to understand what is method signature, right? So I saw a lot of developers, they do not understand what is method signature basically. So let's say we have a method is called, here we can see a method, right? There are two methods I have defined in the doc class. When somebody asks you what is the method signature of this method, then method signature first of all does not include a return type, any access modifier or non-access modifier. Method signature basically includes the method name and whatever parameter you are passing. Here we don't pass any parameter. If you pass some parameter, that also includes the that is also part of the method signature. So method signature is nothing but that includes method name and parameters. If you pass the any parameter, that's the basically method signature, right? That doesn't include any basically return type, access modifier or non-access modifier, right? So that's the basically your method signature. Now let's try to understand what is method overriding. In a parent-child relation between classes, if method in subclass has the same signature as the parent class method, then the method is said to be overridden by the subclasses. And this process is called method overriding, right? So here you can see, here I have a animal class, and here you can see a method is called eating, right? And I have a same method signature in the child class. Here dog is the child class because that extends animal. And here I have a method signature with the same method signature, right? And in that case, this is basically called the overridden method, right? Now we'll talk about the static method and overloading. Static methods in Java can be overloaded just as instance methods. So it is possible to have two or more static methods having the same name, but the parameters are different in types or numbers, right? So I can show you some classes within the JDK. Like let's press Control Shift T and try to search a class. Let's see, very famous utility class is called collections in java.util package, and here you'll get some methods which is overloaded methods. One of the best example is sort. Here you can see there is a two method with the same name, but if you look into the parameters, one sort method takes list of arguments and another list and comparator. So this is called overloaded method, right? If you go to the arrays class, you'll get handful of method overloaded methods like arrays, right? So we have a class is called, press Control Shift T and search for arrays, and here that belongs to the java.util package. You'll get a lot of overloaded within this method. You have a sort with different parameter, right? You have a parallel sort with different parameters. You'll get a lot of basically overloaded methods, right? So I hope you understood what is basically overloading, right? Now here in this video, mostly we'll talk about the with respect to overriding, whether a static method can be overridden or not. There are some of the points you should keep in mind, like just like instance method, in case of static methods also which differ only in the return type, are not said to be the overloaded. So you cannot overload the method just by changing the return type only, right? So now second point, we'll have to keep in mind two methods, with one as a static and one normal instance method are also not considered to be overloaded methods. Like here I have one static method, and you cannot define a same method, not same non-static method within the same class. If you try to do so, you will get the compilation error. That will not consider as a overloading, right? Now let's talk about the static method and overriding. Now a static method cannot be overridden in Java, though it is possible to have a static method with same signature in the subclass, but in that case subclass method hides the superclass method rather than overriding. There won't be any runtime polymorphism in that case, as static methods are bound during compilation time. They are not resolved at runtime, and that's the reason a static method you cannot override. So here you can see I have a super class is called animal, child class dog, which extends animal. And here if you look into the method, is this method, I have a method with the same signature in the subclass. So do you think here overriding happens? No, overriding will not be happen for the static method. Basically if you try to even if you try to put @override annotation, then compiler will not throw any exception for this eating method, right? Because this is instance method, you can easily override, right? So eating method is over here with the same signature I have over here. But @override, if you try to put before a static method, this will show you a compilation error immediately, because a static method cannot be overridden, right? Saying that the method running of type dog must override or implement super type method. This is kind of indication you cannot basically override a static method in Java, right? Now I have a client program. So let me save this class, change it. And here you can see what I have done basically. So here I have created a reference of a parent class, and I have assigned an object of child class, that is dog, and I'm trying to call the running method as well as eating method, and both method is available in the parent class as well as child class. But here running method is a static method, right, which I have also defined in the subclass, but eating is an instance method. So for eating, not a problem, overriding will happen happily. But let's see what output we get. So here if you are expecting basically running, for running overriding should happen, if your expectation, then child class running method should be called, because this reference is holding the child class object. And of course here there is no doubt you'll get output from the child class eating method, because for instance method overriding will happen, but for this overriding will not happen. So what happened in this case, here I have given the comment, here no runtime polymorphism, so parent class method will be called, right? So if I run this application, then you'll see the output. What output? So for first call, what we are getting, animal is running, means we are getting output from the parent class itself. But for second call, animal.eating, we are getting output from the child class itself, right? And that's the reason this is printing dog is eating. So this is coming from this method, right? So here it can be seen that even if the reference of child class is assigned to the parent class object, parent class method is called, not the child class, right? As for the another method that is called eating, runtime polymorphism happens if we need to call the child class if you have a child class, if you want to call the child class static method, then how we can call? So basically here if you would have observed here, compiler is showing some warning, because here I'm trying to call running method by this reference, But compiler is telling, hey, this is running method is a static method. Directly you can refer by the class. Why you are calling by the this reference? So here what I'll do, I'll directly call by the animal, by class name itself. Sorry guys, by class name itself. And here I'll get outputs. I will get the same output, right? And if you want to call running method of your child class, means dog class, then directly you can call by the class name itself, right? So I hope you understood. So always you will have to keep in mind, if somebody tells you can we override a static method or not, then answer is absolutely no, you cannot override static method. Now let's go through some key points when we talk about the whether static method can be overload or can we override or not. Then three things we will have to keep in mind. First point, we can have a static overloaded method in Java which have the same name but differ in types or number of parameters. Now second point, static methods cannot be overridden in Java. Any method with the same signature in subclass will hide the superclass method, not override it. Now third point, static methods are resolved at compile time, not at runtime. Thus overriding a static method is not possible. So that's all I wanted to discuss in this video tutorial. I hope you enjoy learning this video. If you really like this video, then hit on the like button. Don't forget to share and subscribe my YouTube channel. Guys, big thank you for watching this video, and see you next video tutorial.